I've made a whole lot of videos showing you how to create artwork for your Twitch channel or even for your YouTube channel. I've shown you how to use templates, how to create stuff from scratch, how to get inspiration from your favorite video games in order to create your own artwork. But today, I want to push your creativity, but at the same time, be a little lazy. And basically, we're going to use graphics from a video game directly in order to create some artwork. We're going to create maybe a starting soon screen. We could make banners, panels using them. But of course, if you want to spend the least amount of time possible and also get amazing professionally made graphics for your Twitch streams or your YouTube channel, you can always use today's sponsor. And today's sponsor is Owned. Owned has the biggest library of overlay packs for both Twitch streamers and YouTube streamers. Owned basically provides you with everything you need to customize your channel. My favorite feature right now is the animated emote maker. You can use emotes that you already uploaded to Twitch, you can upload new emotes from your computer, or you can straight up make your own emotes from the website and use those to animate. And right now, you can get 50% off of all products if you log in into your own pro account. And simply logging in is completely free. I'll be sure to put a link in the description, but you can check it out over at Owned. owned.gg/gaellevel. That is owned3d.gg/gaellevel. Alright, so the idea actually came to me yesterday when I was playing Townscaper on my live stream. And this is Townscaper, a super cozy game that allows you to create a little town. Buildings, towers, bridges, everything. It is as simple as it gets, but there's a couple of features that are super interesting. Let me create a quick town. So as you can see, depending on how you set up your houses, there can be multiple types of architectures, but that's not the point. The point here is while I was playing around with this game, I thought the graphics look amazing. This looks great. This looks like something that I could use in a way, basically as my starting soon screen, for example. You can put this in a banner, you can put this on panels, just create your little town and maybe I would make it animated. If you just capture this, for example, just with the water waves, that's a pretty cool looking animation. Something that I probably wouldn't be able to do if I were to 3D model this and then create the waves and 2D animation and all of that. On top of that, we have extra options. For example, we can control the sun. And look at that. Just this as a looped animation can look super cool. Or maybe you can do a time lapse of the day and night cycle. Something like this, maybe. And just capture that, and that's it. Now the game itself allows you to take screenshot in pretty much whatever resolution you want. You can also export as OBJ. If you don't know, that's like a 3D thing. You can 3D print your little town if you want to, including the little pigeons and stuff. You can also put them in animating software such as Blender and stuff like that, although the textures are not gonna necessarily be imported correctly. You can put it in a broadcasting software that uses 3D such as Polypop, which is something that I use. You can watch my tutorials on that. Or you can video capture a camera movement and just put it on loop. I even had the idea to create a town where I could maybe write some messages. For example, those towers spell the word hi. You could probably make a logo out of it. You have access to a grid here so you can see how it's laid out. Maybe I want to do something like a G for Gael. For a video intro, you have a normal looking town and then boom, it spells my name. During my live stream, for example, I created this little town and I exported it as a .obj file. I put it in a 3D software called Blender and I was able to export this as a render. Now I'm using Townscaper as an example, but this is something you can do in any video game. As long as you can try to kind of clear out the UI so you can have a clear image, you can put yourself in a cinematic-ish position and just capture what you see and boom, that could be, again, your starting soon screen, that could be part of your banner, that could be anything. Of course, I know all the people who try to nitpick my videos are going to talk about copyright laws and all of that stuff. As long as you're not selling it, technically I would say you could consider this personal use. Now of course, if you want to be super duper safe, you can contact the devs of the game, contact the company that has the game. In this case, I think this game was built by one single person. You can contact them, tell them, hey, is it okay if I use a screen capture of my video game as a starting soon screen, as a banner? Since you can play the video game and broadcast yourself playing the video game without DMCA repercussions, I believe that as long as you're not pretending that you made this artwork from scratch, you should be fine. But again, if you need permission, just ask for permission. This game also gives you the option to have have like a flat type of design versus the realistic shadows and ambient occlusion. It also gives you this version without any textures, and you can still play around with the sun. So I would find in my settings, pin UI, I can turn this off. So I'm not gonna have the colors here unless I actually look for them, and I can close this and boom, I have this right there, and I can just window capture this in OBS, for example, right? If I wanna make a starting soon screen, for example, I would probably put it on the side. I'm holding middle mouse button here. And just like that, I'll just try to find a way to loop this. Even if it doesn't loop perfectly, it will still look good. You just put your text over there, it says starting soon, and that's it. And I could even make it, I don't even have to capture it. I could just show you right now in OBS Studio. I can just add a text source and just create it live in front of you without even capturing anything. And just like that, I just added this text in OBS right now, and you have a pretty great looking starting soon screen. It doesn't have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be this super intricate artwork. It can be that simple, especially if this basically represents what people can expect on the stream, right? If you do a cozy stream, this looks good, but I don't know, if you play Apex or something like that and you manage to get some sort of cinematic angle and you can throw it in a loop, just screen capture and then boom, if you have to scale to get the UI out of there, it's that simple. And I can customize this. All I have to do is get in the game and... For example, if I wanted to have more animation than just the stagnant water, I could just come here in the sun settings, hit record in OBS, go up with my mouse, wait a couple seconds, go down, wait for the lights to come back up, and hit stop recording. And that would be kind of a perfect loop. Maybe the water wouldn't loop perfectly, but still, that's how easy it is. It takes 3 seconds. And of course, you can change the style, you can change the colors, and all of that good stuff. All right, I believe my point is made. You can click on screenshot, for example, if you wanted to take a 1080p screenshot, you would go ahead and just find it in your folders. There it is. And I can open up like a free website like Photopea and just start customizing it. Drag, drop, you're ready. T to add text. I just realized that other text is still there because it's in OBS. Let me turn that off. All right, this is what we're making. And that's just how fast you could make it if you were to make a static one, right? Maybe you're not too comfortable with video, or maybe your computer can't handle video. We'll turn down the opacity here, and I could probably make a little social bar here. Just like that. And if you wanted to add like your chat, or maybe you want to put like a clips compilation while you're starting, you can create a little screen underneath here. Just group everything together and just bring this back up like that. I personally like putting a clips compilation. And yeah, we would just put a border. And we'll probably create a mask in order to make it match and all that stuff. But it's up to you. Right now, I'm just creating the border and it should look like this. That simple. And this is a pretty good looking starting soon screen, made in a couple of minutes with just one screenshot. But the process of creating panels, banners, and all that stuff that I mentioned, it's really that easy. I can export this as PNG. And then I'll be able to add it to OBS as an image source, just like that. Now, the goal of this video is not necessarily to show you a step-by-step on how to manipulate pictures or anything like that. It's mostly to kind of boost your creativity a little bit, but also show you that you don't have to dig that deep to go find things that look good that might make your stream or your YouTube channel look good. You want an intro, you can just do a little screen capture. You already have the tools. You have OBS Studio and you have Photopea, for example, which is completely free. There's no excuse, really. I can't really force you to be creative, but hopefully this video will give you a little hint and maybe help you explore things that you may not have thought of before. All right, one more example that I really want to show you. So this is a screenshot that I took from the game directly, right? So I went in my town, I zoomed in somewhere, and I took a picture. the screenshot with the screenshot function. And I realized there's no depth of field. The camera doesn't go blurry when things are close or further away from it. So from the screenshot, I brought this into Photoshop and I basically selected the parts that were closer to the camera and I added a filter called lens blur. And then I did more stuff. I added a vignette to make the emphasis on the part that I wanted to be in focus. I added a little bloom effect on the lights and this is the result. Oh, I also added out of focus stars because it would be out of focus in real life if the depth of field was that shallow. So that's the before and that's the after. Before, after. Before, after. So by just spending a little bit of time, for example, I could put like starting soon screen here. I could put my name, my logo, and put some socials and boom, turn this into a banner or into whatever, an offline image, for example. That would be pretty cool for Twitch. I just wanted to show you an example of taking things that are already there and basically manipulating them a little bit into your advantage and make them look cool and maybe integrate them into part of your artwork. I'm not gonna say you don't necessarily have to pay an artist. You should always like the best solution is to pay an artist, a professional, to make things for you. But if you can't afford an artist, that you're not gonna pay an artist. There's a lot of nifty, creative ways that you can acquire some cool looking artwork. And that was just using one single video game. So if your stream is more about FPS game, again, open your FPS game, trying to get in a cinematic position. And if you can't get that cinematic position, take a screenshot, bring it into Photopea, manipulate it in order to make it look better. I will be leaving a link to Townscaper, the game, in the description. Check it out. I also got this game for free. It's not a free game, but I got it for free using Lurkit. And if you want to learn about Lurkit, watch my video on the subject. So I already made a video showing you how to get games for free. And on top of that, I'm showing you how to use, as an example, this game in order to have artwork. So subscribe is what I'm gonna ask. Also follow me on Twitch because a lot of this I actually did live. Anyways, I gotta thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.